As of August 24th of 2025, there are currently 42 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is 2 less than were erupting last week. Of these, the volcano with the longest continuously ongoing eruption is Vanuatu's Yasur volcano. It has been erupting for approximately 800 years straight at a low to moderate intensity via both primarily Strombolian and Vulcanian eruptions. This prolonged activity has all occurred from its ever-growing cinder cone, which in that time span has reached a prominence of 306 meters or 1,004 feet. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Russia, near constant rumbling was felt at a settlement more than 7 miles away from twin active volcanoes, with this occurring alongside a strong earthquake swarm. Meanwhile, in Italy, multiple vents from Mount Etna fed a slowly advancing but lengthy series of new blocky lava flows. And, in what is this week's top story, after a more than 2-week-long pause, Hawaii's Kilauea volcano finally produced its 31st episode of strong lava fountaining on August 22nd and 23rd. Yet, what made this episode unique was that while yes, it did produce sustained 100-meter-high lava fountains, these were also horizontally ejected to a further distance of 300 meters or 984 feet. In other words, Kilauea's latest nearly 13-hour-long period of lava fountaining involved an unusually strong lateral lava fountain, which occurred primarily from its northern vent from 2:04 p.m. on August 22nd until it abruptly ceased at 2:52 a.m. the following morning. If you are wondering how these lava fountains formed, it was likely via a similar method to manually placing a thumb over part of a garden hose and watching it spray outwards sideways. Part of Kilauea's magma conduit at the surface was likely clogged with debris, causing a horizontal spray of molten rock to originate from its north summit vent. Its southern vent also created a lesser growing lava flow beginning at 4 p.m., while an area in between these aforementioned vents opened up at around 7:23 p.m. local time. All of this lava was harmlessly confined to the southwest portion of Kilauea's summit caldera, covering just over 75% of this caldera floor. In total, this episode of activity output 8.4 million cubic meters of molten rock via an average lava fusion rate of 185 cubic meters per second. Now, it appears to me that episode 32 will begin of Kilauea's cyclical activity sometime between August 31st and September 8th, 2025. Meanwhile, at Mount Etna, for the first time in several months, a series of lava flows emerged from the volcano's summit region. The first of these emerged at 2,980 meters elevation on August 14th at a fissure approximately 1,200 meters west-southwest of the volcano's southeast crater. Across the next week, continuous spattering from this fissure fed a lava flow that descended into an uninhabited area, traveling 2.1 kilometers or 1.3 miles and reaching 2,270 meters elevation. Then, on August 20th, two new vents developed and also began simultaneously feeding fresh lava flows, one at 3,100 meters elevation further upslope of the aforementioned August 14th vent, and one directly from the existing southeast crater. All three of these lava flows, which I interpret to have a tracky basalt composition, are flowing to the southwest or south and have so far covered an area of 0.56 square kilometers or 138.4 acres. And in Russia, just when I thought that the triggered activity at six volcanoes via the July 30th magnitude 8.8 quake was continuing to subside, reality threw in a wrench when, on August 23rd, one of these volcanoes and a neighboring seventh volcano began experiencing increasing activity. What I am referring to are the Kambalny and Koshelev volcanoes on the southwest of the Kamchatka Peninsula, 20 kilometers southwest of the caldera of Kuril Lake. While Kambalny last erupted in 2017 and had been producing a declining earthquake swarm for the past 3 weeks, Koshelev had shown no signs of life until yesterday, having not erupted since 1690. During the 24-hour period preceding the publishing of this video, nearly 200 volcano tectonic earthquakes struck across those two volcanoes, most importantly occurring alongside periods of constant rumbling that could suggest magma movement. It is unknown what might happen next, but once again, we need to keep an eye on a few of Kamchatka's volcanoes. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on August 23rd of 2025.